Okay, boss. We finished loading all this. Now we are supposed to load attribute table for customer, boss. So what's the customer key? This is Infopix. So I'll go to my provider. AW sales into the master data and I'll insert this info provider. I want to check this file and this is fine or not. Open desktop. Customer details. So customer key. It's key fine, and then geography key done, and first name, middle name, last name, first name, last name, middle name, and then first name is done. Email address. We're going to get some error now. Email address, yearly income. Okay. Address line 1 and 2. And then phone number, it's fine. It does match my file. Okay. So I have an attribute for this. I need to load data from this file. So what will be the step here? Data source. Let me choose my source system, file, and then what, test file. So what type of data source will I create when my target is attribute? Attribute data source. Key underscore edit here, and type of data source is attribute data source. Extraction from the file AW customer details 1 CSV file comma proposal. Ready to propose. So it fails because I've kept the file open, so make sure the file is closed. Done. Let it propose. Just want this as what? See. Even this as now see. Yield income integer is fine. I'm okay with that. So. Yearly income. Okay. I think yearly income has got some int 2 only takes it till 5, so int 4 again. I just have to refresh it. Okay, done. Save it, read it. So next would be, what will be next aspect? Connecting both. Right click, say what, create transformations, source is data source, and this is my test source system, customer key to customer key, geography, first name to F name, middle name to M name, and then L last name to L name, email address to email address, address line 1 and address line 2, and phone number is this, yearly income. This one. Done. Okay. Activate your transformations. So what would be next steps? Just run your info packages and schedule the load. See, irrespective of the data quality, whether there is some data errors in it, it does bring it to what? PSA, data source. So InfoPax doesn't throw any error if there is a problem with data quality. Okay. So I've got some 18,000 some records. Are they still coming in? Now you can observe this. See, now 18,000 records, right? It is bringing one packet in 1,000 records. The packet size it is taking is 1,000. So it brought in so many packets, 19 packets. Why it is 1,000? We'll see. How do we control more? Suppose if I wanted 2,000 in one packet, we can still control it also. So now let me, what is the next step? Create DTP. So you're getting used to this flow, data source, transformation, info package, DTP, are still feeling tough person. Inka tough unda? Error rale. So maintain master database. I was expecting that it will throw an error for this @ symbol and then dot or something. Suppose if it fails for that special characters, okay. What you'll have to do is you'll have a T code called RSKC. RSKC, and it is where you basically allow all the special. Suppose if it fails for a special character like @, you just give it and say execute. So these characters will be permitted into the system. Yeah. If there is some suppose if there is invalid character and if you won't allow it, you will allow it that in RSKC. But if you don't want allow this, you won't remove it. The only option is you go to the PSA. You can do editing, right? You can remove those and then. If it is 1,000 records, if you don't want to edit, you can do an emergency transport where you write a transformation rule where you say replace the special character with the space, blank space. You even do a routine which will remove that space also, which will remove that special character also. So what's the next file? Next is what? Sales territory bus. Sales territory key, I think, yeah. So let me go to BW info objects, search for this key. I have it and this has got only attributes, and these are the three attributes here. Let me open the file and check whether it's all fine with that. Sales territory, so it's region, country, and what? Group. Yeah. So region, country, and group. It's all fine. Yeah, good. So I just have to insert this as info provider. Yeah, done. So now what is the next step? Is got to create your data sources. So you wanted to go with attributes. So the naming you try to do this way. Edit here. Not mandatory, you can give in any name. Okay. File is sales territory. Let me close out this file. Number of headers to big node 1, CSV, and then what? Commerce software proposal fields. Okay. Let this be non-same. Done. So what is that you do? You connect your provider. This is the data source with the transformations. Territory key and country, region. So basically your transfer structure should match your file. It need not match the sequence of the target. No. You can have zigzag mapping source. Data source info package. error, what does it say? Updating attributes that is not valid. What happens? How come it is not valid? Let me see, what is it? Data record 01 United States is not valid. Key 0 is invalid and invalid United States file for that country. Let me check the infobox settings of country. Country. So is it enabled for lowercase? But I was getting a lowercase letter, so that's the problem. So the one option is I get into this and get into that country, change my object to hold what, lowercase in it, or you should write a routine to convert it to uppercase, but it would look nice with caps and lowercase. So now I'm just running. Let me delete that bad request which has failed. You understand what was the problem, right? Now it's fine. So that's about, now the master is also loaded. Done?